everyone, welcome to the Nomad Talks. My name is Emily and I'm the co-founder of Nomad Junkies. If you are dreaming of paella, fiesta, and playa, well, you are at the right place because today we're going to talk about living and working in Spain after the pandemic. Let's welcome our guest, Elena from Calgary.
Hi.
Hi, Elena.
Hi, Emily.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you. And thank you for joining us today. Are you in Calgary right now?
I am, yes.
You must miss Spain.
I do. Yeah, it's been a long time now since we've been back there. So definitely missing the warm weather.
And thanks for joining us for this live video. If you are watching us, say hi to us in the comments below and share with us where are you watching from, and let us know if the quality of the video is great, if the sound is great. Is it okay for you, Elena?
Yes, everything's perfect.
Okay, great. So let's start. Would you tell us how long were you in Spain for, and what type of visa did you have?
Yes, of course. So in total now at this point in time, I've probably spent around 2 years in total in Spain. And the type of visa I had, it was a an open work permit type of visa. So I was able to go to live there for up to a year, which was great. It was totally open for what jobs I wanted to do. I had the chance to travel around. So the visa was awesome and it lasted for a whole year. So I spent the whole entire year there. A couple months prior to the visa as well, and then many months after the visa expired as well.
Yeah, so if you're interested about this visa, it's almost like a secret, but Canadians between 18 to 35 can get their working holiday visa to stay and work for up to 12 months in Spain like you did. And if you are watching, we will put the link below to get more information, find out the cost, the process to apply, and all the requirements. In your case, Elena, where did you travel in Spain during your working holiday visa? And what was your favorite place?
We had a chance to travel around a lot. We saw a lot of Spain, which I'm very thankful for. Barcelona, Madrid, Granada, Ronda, Malaga. I went to some of the islands too, Mallorca. So lots and lots of travel within Spain. And then outside of Spain as well, we were right next to Portugal. So a lot of time in Portugal. We made a couple trips around as well to Belgium. Flights were so cheap. So we took advantage of all of that. So yeah, a lot of traveling around during that year, which was amazing.
Yeah, it's a good, Europe is such a good place, especially Spain, to have like a base camp and this type of visa, you can get in and out as much as you want to explore. So
exactly,
it's really great. And now that we talk about like the travel part of the working holiday visa, let's talk about the work part of this type of visa. What step did you take to find a job, and was it easy? What kind of work did you have there?
Yeah, believe it or not, it was actually really, really easy. For native English speakers in Spain, the opportunities are endless. There's teaching jobs anywhere in a major city. I was living in the south in Sevilla, and there's opportunity everywhere. So I ended up living with a Spanish family for a portion of time, and I taught their kids English. I don't have any teaching background myself. But it was a great opportunity. So there's many different ways you can find jobs. There's tons of Facebook groups out there that they're always posting for opportunities. A couple different sites. There's another one called Workaway. So it's easy to find a job. And especially if you're an English speaker, there's endless opportunity. So it's a great place to find work.
So even if you don't speak Spanish, or maybe you're learning Spanish, it's still like it's still an option. It's still easy to find.
It is. That's probably the best way you can go into it, because they need English speakers. I mean, even with the hospitality industry, serving, bartending, you name it, You'll pick up Spanish quicker than you might think. When I first moved there, I spoke zero Spanish. Zero.
Really?
Yeah, none. So it was challenging at the beginning, of course, but it's the best way that you can learn the language as well. So it's totally fine if you don't speak any Spanish. You'll make it through.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. That's good. Now let's talk about, we talk about travel, we talk about work. Let's talk about money.
Yes.
Did you have any saving before going to Spain?
I did have some, not a lot. So I wouldn't worry too much about the savings. And for the working holiday visa, one of the processes you do have to prove you have a certain amount of money. It's a low amount. It's just to kind of be sure that you'll make it there okay. But I didn't have a ton of money saved, which I was maybe concerned about at some point, but life in Spain is very doable. Very, very cheap, especially for someone coming from a place like Calgary. So definitely you want to have some savings just to kind of have that comfort zone. But I wouldn't be too concerned about it, having a huge amount of money before you go to live and work in a place like Spain, depending on the city though. Because for example, Madrid, Barcelona, rent is super high. But I was living in the south, so everything in the south is quite a bit lower cost of living wise. Yeah.
Okay, that's a really good tip.
Yeah.
And would you say that the money earned during your working holiday visa was enough to cover your cost of living there?
It was, yes. I was never in a point where I was stressed out about that. Like I said, day-to-day life there, it's very low in cost. So it all completely balanced itself out. I was still earning enough to be able to comfortably travel, go out for meals multiple times a week, and take little trips on the weekend. So yeah, it was all very balanced.
It's great. So it's basically like if you're traveling for free because you make the money and then you can travel with your money and you cover your cost of living plus the other trips around. So that's really cool.
Yeah.
And then let's go back on the lifestyle in Spain. Mm-hmm. So what are the main differences between living in Spain and living in Canada? Did you have to adjust, to adapt?
Yes, lots of adjusting. You can't even really put them on the same level. It's just a totally, totally different lifestyle. Of course, I was there for enjoyment too and for travel. So just everything with that was different. But everything in Spain just seems to be at a so much slower pace. No one's ever in a rush. You can sleep in. Everyone's just outside enjoying a coffee. Siestas in the afternoon. Almost everyone I met has siestas. Staying up late. So yeah, the lifestyle is just totally different. Everyone there and the locals, they seem to really have an easygoing flow of lifestyle. So it's totally different. In Canada, of course, so I'm always working. So I feel like it's go, go, go all the time. So it was a really nice pace there. A huge adjustment though, of course, because I'm not used to that. But after a few weeks, I was loving it and taking siestas every day. So I miss it. But yeah, the lifestyle it's great there.
Is it true that like they eat really late? Like it's really different, like dinner, supper?
Yes, that was another huge adjustment. We still kind of do like Spanish time here in Canada. But yeah, it's all different. Lunch you would typically eat, for us at least, we would eat lunch around 2 p.m., 3 p.m., and dinner around 11 at night.
So what time do they have breakfast if they eat lunch at 2?
Yeah, pretty much whenever, like 11 or so.
11, oh my God, everything is so like
later. Yeah, it's all so much later. And even little things like having coffee. Like here I have a cup of coffee in the morning, maybe in the afternoon, but in Spain I would have a cortado, which is a little cup of coffee. It's a really good one after dinner. So at midnight you're having another cup of coffee. So yeah, totally different.
That's great. And it must be also different, like maybe like the way like in Canada because of the weather. So I guess like the way of living, it has to be a little bit different.
Yes, it's totally different. I've never had a chance to get to know a country so well where life is all lived outside of the house, which is so different than in Canada. In Canada, people buy these big houses and you're inside your house. In the winter time, of course, you spend most of your time inside. Maybe if you have to go outside, you do, and you bear the minus 30 degrees in Calgary. but in Spain, very little time is spent inside the house. The homes are much smaller. They're much more traditional and older. And life is outside on the streets. Like, you have breakfast out at a little cafe and you're out all night long. So yeah, it's very, very different when it comes to that.
Well, that makes me want to be in Spain right now. It's like a pretty, like, different, a pretty chill life. And
yeah, it's a great life there. Yeah.
Finally, what advice would you give to someone who would like to do a working holiday visa in Spain like you did? What advice can you give?
I would probably say just go for it, because the visa process, although it is challenging, I did it completely by myself. And it was not hard. It's definitely doable, but there's a lot of steps. So at many points I was kind of thinking, wow, this is a lot of work, but I'm so thankful that I did it. In the end, it was easy. Looking back on it now, to actually get the visa, it wasn't challenging at all. And I think just not to be afraid, because it's scary, right? You're moving across the world to a different country by yourself where you don't speak the language. So I think it's easy to have doubts about that along the way. So just to kind of stay positive, and when you arrive, just be open to the new culture and to meeting new people and getting out there and even just speaking when you don't know the language. It's the best way to get a great experience out of it. So yeah, I think just not to be afraid and go for it, because it will probably be the most rewarding thing that you can do.
Oh, that's great. That's a good advice, a good push to realize this dream. And we're talking about meeting new people. Someone told me that you met someone special when you were over there.
I did, yeah. So that was, it's so crazy to think, because that was so many years ago now. It was when I was 22, sorry. When I very first moved to Seville, and on my third day there, I met my now fiance, Fernando. Thank you. Yeah, it's been a long, long process. But
it's insane, right? That's what I heard.
Yeah, he's from Seville. So yeah, it's crazy how it all came together. So my third day there, but when we initially first met, I didn't have the visa. So I was just there for the 3 months. Tourist, yeah, just exploring. And then it's when I came back to Canada that I then got the visa to move back, and then I was there for the whole entire year. So yeah, it's been a lot of back and forth. It's long times of long distance, but now we both live together in Canada, in Calgary, for just over a year. So yeah.
So a little bit more than a work and a travel experience. So you got the work holiday visa.
Yeah, a lot more. I was not expecting that. But yes, it all worked out amazing.
Well, thank you so much. We're going to share the picture that you took there. They're really amazing. Thank you for sharing your experience with us. Those watching now, it's your turn to ask your question about the working holiday experience in Spain or just in general. And don't be shy, write them below in the comments. And we're going to do a little bit of answering these questions in live with you, Elena.
Yes.
Okay, let's pick one first question. I feel Canadian question. What is the weather like in Spain all year round?
It's beautiful. It does get cold in the winter time, not anything like cold here. But I noticed it because in Spain, the homes don't have heating at all. Ooh. There's zero heating inside the homes in Spain. So December, January, it might be around 10 degrees and it's a wet cold. So I did have to get a winter jacket, which I didn't think I would have to. But the weather there is incredible. It's maybe just those 2 months where it's a little bit cooler, some rainy months. But other than that, the weather is awesome. Probably the best time, I would say, to visit Spain would be September, because the temperatures have dropped a little bit and it's not so busy with tourists, and the weather is incredible. 25 to 33, and the fall there is just gorgeous.
That's good. That's good. Yeah. And, we'll take another question. Is it really cheaper living in Spain than in Canada? And I will personally add myself, maybe you can give us an example of like an evening out, like mm-hmm. how much it costs.
Yes, it's way cheaper. So in Seville too, like I mentioned, it's quite a bit less. If you're in one of the major cities, you really have to find the local spots because it's so easy to get caught up in a touristy restaurant or bar. My main advice with this is never go somewhere that has any English advertised. If they have an English menu, you don't want to go there. So I know it's more challenging, but yeah, you want to go to the local spots. But just to give you an idea, I know my mom and dad came to visit us in Seville, and we took them to our favorite tapas place, Duo Tapas. And we had an incredible meal. We had some beers at the start, probably like 15 tapas all shared, coffee, dessert, and a bottle of wine. And at the end, we all took turns to guess how much the bill was, and no one was even close. And it was around 40 euros all of us for that meal, including a whole bottle of wine.
So 50, 60 Canadian dollar for four people in a restaurant with wine in your favorite tapas place.
Yeah, and the food is amazing. Every single dish there is incredible.
Yeah. Awesome. So let's take one last question in the live. Okay. Oh, that's maybe this one. While you were in Spain, what did you miss the most about Canada?
That's a good question. Yeah, it's a funny one because I think being Canadian, we live here and I'm so thankful that I'm from Canada. And then I don't really realize that I appreciate it so much until I leave. And being gone for a whole year, it definitely makes you realize some things that you miss. So I think I just miss, of course, my family, my friends. Mm-hmm. It was a long time to be away. I still got to see them. But even just the people here, people are very friendly in Spain too, so don't get me wrong, but Canadians just have a certain thing about them. They're smiling, they hold the door for you. If you accidentally bump into them, they say sorry. So I think just the familiar faces and the people are very friendly here. And I miss the mountains too, of course. I live like an hour from Banff and we go to see the mountains pretty much every weekend. So. Yeah, coming back now and seeing them kind of with new eyes. They're super beautiful. So I definitely miss them when I'm gone as well.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thanks again. And if you have questions that we did not answer today, write it down in the comments and we will make sure to reply to every one of you. We also have someone from International Experience Canada that can answer any specific question about the working holiday visa. Elena and myself will be there to answer all the other questions. And you can always visit the International Canada Experience Canada website to get all the details to travel and work abroad as a Canadian. And one last thing is that we have other online events to talk about working and traveling in other exciting destinations with other amazing guests as Elena. And if you're interested about like doing your working holiday visa in New Zealand, Australia, Ireland, Germany, there's more than 30 destinations. We'll put the links below for the events or the video. And I hope to see you soon. And Elena, thank you so much for sharing your experience with us. And I hope to see you traveling more and follow you on social media.
Yes, thank you so much, Emily. I hope so too. Hopefully some travel will be coming my way shortly.
Hopefully after the pandemic, we can all re-travel more.
Fingers crossed.
Yes, thank you so much.